So, good morning, class. I want to believe that this is a class, this is a fourth year class, led by whose class representative is David. My name is Karari. We've met again in your third year, and I would like first of all to welcome you to fourth year. My name is Karari, and I will be taking you for computer graphics. I think before I start, I hope that everyone is well. We are in this season because, and we are doing things this way because of COVID-19. So it's my hope that everyone is well and you are safe wherever you are. And I also hope that you have been able to keep up with your academics despite the fact that you have had that long break. As you can see on the screen, I'll be taking you for that unit, computer graphics. And the unit basically, sorry, I need to display the course outline. So in this unit, as you can see in the course outline, we expected to, at the end of the course, to be able to understand the limitations of producing graphic display both at the hardware and software level, understand how the computer system uses the hardware to produce graphic display, understand how primitive graphical operations are produced and the operations needed to ensure correct display of those operations. We should also be able to produce our own very simple graphic package. Sometimes we don't manage to get to that level, but you're going to strive to see whether we can do that and use and write programs for standard graphical packages. I think this is a basic, these are the objectives of the course. Ideally, it gives you a background for how you can use computer softwares for purposes of altering or creating or managing graphics. I think we've also seen, just to be a little bit broad, that computer graphics has really become an industry by itself, because this is where we have the production of, you know, animations, which have resulted into animation movies, and these movies have yielded millions. We have seen adverts that are based on animations. We know of Bogwa or Fiber, you know, and other, you know, other characters that are created out of animation that are used for advertisement, especially. I think, excuse me. We have also seen movies like Lion King. The Lion King is an old movie, I think, produced in the 90s, and this movie, you know, produced the kind of revenue it produced would challenge several times the GDP of certain countries, even our own country. So you can see the amount of potential that is there in computer graphics. It is not just a unit you are learning, and I'm not saying that we are here to learn about animations per se. We are learning the technology behind that, the science behind those animations, so to say. And this is what we call computer graphics. For us to be able to achieve these objectives, we have split the course into 10 lessons. Most of my units, I try as much as possible to split them to 10 lessons. And lesson 1, we shall have an overview of computer graphics. Lesson 2, we shall have a look at the mathematical background of computer graphics. As you're going to learn, computer graphics has a lot of mathematical background, algebra especially, and here we're talking of vectors, vector analysis. Then we have OpenGL programming, Open Graphic Language. This is the tool we use, actually is like a framework used for purposes of designing computer graphics software. We'll see how we can make curves, transformations, 3D objects. We shall look at camera models and camera control. Why? Because this is where we get the graphics from, which we can manipulate. Sometimes also when you create a graphic, a computer generated graphic, you need to have effects that are similar to those which you find from a photograph taken using a camera or a video taken using a camera. So we're going to be looking at visibility, lighting, reflections, and shading in lesson 8. And then in lesson 9 we shall have texture mapping, and lesson 10 we shall have ray tracing. I would like us to look at briefly at the content of those lessons. Lesson 1, we shall have a definition of terms, history of computer graphics, relation between mathematics and computer graphics, raster displays, and basic line drawing. Lesson 2, mathematical background. We introduce the mathematical background, the points, vectors, notations, basic algebra, matrix algebra. Then we get into OpenGL programming, where we look at GLUT. We shall see exactly what that means. An illustrative example, we shall have modeling and matrices in OpenGL and a simple animation.